I'm back with more Galost Hilorg Fighter of the Invincible Ellie. Ellie the Undying. Happy to leave that sealed off for now. Meliae. The War Axe. 79% pacification due to the low HP. You can just yell it in. Vulnerable to poison, so it's dead. No pillar as yet. It appears my concerns about stair blocking were well founded. Having that problem anyway. Imagine it could be a lot worse had I not cleared things out. Death yaks regenerate very quickly, so I don't think venom kiting is a particularly appropriate strategy for them due to that fact. Because venom has a damage per time ceiling that doesn't scale with XL with character strength. So there are, it, to some degree it scales in terms of the ease and strength of poison that you apply, but and the ease with which you apply it, but the actual damage per time is capped at tier 4, and that doesn't change from D1 to extended. So as monster regeneration over time increases, poison becomes relatively less effective, which is why you can see me now transitioning to using the Morning Star to finish. Venom kiting is a very safe way to get kills because one need not risk going low HP, but it's also rather time inefficient against faster regenerators. Time, of course, translates into ration of the body. Again, block the line of sight. It's not really necessary, but maybe a little bit of lesser healing here would be nice. Close. One step, two smites. In the face of that kind of damage per turn, per time, my only option is greater healing. Unfortunately, it won't do that every time. So those things pump out serious damage per time, and the solution is just... Well, I could have engaged it with the crossbow. Not sure how effective that would be with its EV, but it might have saved me that greater healing. Certainly, I think the lesser healing was the wrong move there, because it can outmaneuver and outdamage. Lesser healing can outmaneuver my line of sight play and then outdamage the lesser healing. That pain axe would be a nice weapon with BO. Sounds like a lone elephant. The whip is also nice because it causes headbutt to proc more. Not retaliation headbutting, I don't think. That's only a Minotaur. Yeah. So that was the remnant of the B-Pack patrolled north. Comfortable engaging them here. Actually, that would be better. Sparkle away. Question is poison or I think I'll do poison first. Just charge this thing. I don't think the venom whip is necessary anymore for Komodos. Bee. A lot of bees. Okay. Let's see how we do here. They're gonna wrap around. So right, obviously greater healing. I was impatient there and relying on Ellie. Would have been smarter to come around this way. Approach indirectly. Stakes are not good, of course. Shouldn't become overconfident. The queen. How should I play this? This is a great enslavement opportunity to turn the poison user on the queen. And let me tank for my ally so that he doesn't die immediately. Questionable use of enslavement, but it was fun. It wasn't really necessary, but it was fun. The alternative was, whoa, I just put myself under penance because I was narrating. Ah, that was stupid. Could use this moment to convert to BO. So that was pretty ugly. Definitely lost focus. Disappointing. I faced Lair 6 without Ellie's support. Should have used the or should have used the arpoise staff while maneuvering around the bees. It's another mistake. Pretty faded this session. Quality of the plays reflecting that. Oops, typo, so I'll heal that monster. Okay, he's healed. And I want to disable mode. Which I believe is Control Y. Control Y. Okay, and the next wizard just doesn't notify. Under a treat, I think. my options are. Teleport makes sense. Too happy with how that went. Should have retreated sooner. Perhaps. ways, this does demonstrate the difference that Ellie makes. Ah, no longer under penance. Guess I got away with just one teleport scroll as the cost. Looks like it doesn't announce when the penance drops. Just leaves the end vault, which I definitely want Ellie up for. It's the elephant's one. Thank you. Escaped the elephant trap with minimal piety expenditure and a teleport. That's good. I guess what I should have done is close the door on the anaconda and immediately retreat it, because the dire elephants had flanked me. I wasn't sure exactly how that worked. I didn't realize they were going to come from behind. I thought they would be coming from that inner room or something. Well, I knew the statues were going to transform, so I didn't know exact timing of when that would occur, though. Not sure I can even take this thing. Yeah, this is not going to work. The right thing to do is just to come back later. So it gives me a gap. Could spend resources to take them down, of course, but there is no need. I have a good shot at walking away from her with repulsion and shield. That would be ideal because of his ability to mark me. Harold might be valuable to keep around as a source of mark. In order to pull patrols to stairs. I haven't tried that before, so his weapon is not impressive. Maybe I'll keep him alive and park him. But if I park him, I'm cut off from my stash. It would be simpler to do this later with the Vault Sentinel and not now. It's not like I need. how the monkeys can open doors. Six percent chance to pacify is quite low. Can't count on that. No chances to spend gold yet. The net is a poor choice, given that she can haste yourself with Berserk. Her MR is high. Her AC is her vulnerability. Should read that scroll. Not now, but later. That's actually an interesting list to read now. If silence will prevent her berserk, but I don't think it will. About the scroll. Seems like the best option is just to counter Berserk. Use the Evening Star. Oh, encounters your region. And reduces the window in which she has opportunities to berserk. So it's the correct counter to her. Good. Was easy enough. Still no work. Danger here is the venom dagger. That's a minimal one. Why did he not follow? It's not better than my venom whip, but. Be useful for an orc follower. Oh well. The Phantom Mirror might be a strategic resource worth saving for some branch, but the typical use for it is learning in Hydra or TRJ. I might have learning, but I don't approve of using it on TRJ. I'll just hang on to it, it's a good trump card. Versus uniques and whatnot, which may be immune to heal other. Okay, I think that's enough for this session. My only concern at the moment is 3 teleports is a bit low, but they're quite common, so I'm sure that'll build back up by the time it matters. And with Ellie Piety at 6 stars, it's fine. See you.